Now we will do our first row, row 1A with color 1. And, well, you see my chart lying here. And actually, at this moment, with the way we will be doing this version, we don't need it yet, so I will put it aside. Because now we will first do a row of filet crochet. We will be making the first row of squares. And, here I've done my long tail setup. And I know a lot of people use 3 chains for the first double crochet, and maybe you use a different way of doing your first double crochet. That's totally fine. Choose the way that you prefer. I will be using just the simple 3 chain for the first double crochet, and then I also have to do 1 chain, because between 2 double crochets goes 1 chain. So I will start with making 4 chains. So, put the tail aside. 1, 2, 3, 4. And, well, this was the place where I put my stitch marker, so I can go wrong here. So this is the place where our first double crochet goes. And, well, I can see if I can put my hook next to it. I probably have to take it out and not forget where the stitch is. So this is the place where you have to insert your first stitch, first double crochet. So we have done our first square. Of course, you can also check and count, especially if you are a beginner with crochet, this really helps to get you a nice start. So now we will do 1 chain. Something I wanted to tell you, sometimes I forgot to make a chain, and that is important. And then I had to look, oh, did I do it or not? But you can see it this way. You now see here these 2 loops. And that means you haven't done your chain stitch yet. So chain 1, and now you see the difference between these stitches. So now you've done your chain. And then we will skip 1 stitch of the setup row and make our next double crochet into this stitch. So chain 1, and then I will do my, I skip here 1, here into the next, chain 1, skip this 1, double crochet, chain 1, skip 1, insert, you always pick up, I will show you. That's a nice thing about this setup. You can easily see where to insert your hook, because the holes show very, very clearly. And if you insert your hook, you have 2 loops on your hook. So, and now you have come to your stitch marker. And these are the signs that tell you, okay, now you have to check. You have come, you have done this last double crochet in the stitch before the stitch marker. And that is correct. If you have come to the stitch marker, then you have done something wrong with counting. And, then you have to redo that part again. But now we have come to the right place, so that's correct. And now we have done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 holes. So that is also correct, and now we can remove this stitch marker, and we will continue with, okay, you can see I have not made my chain yet, so I will do that chain, and I will go to the next place where I have to, and then we will continue till the next stitch marker. That will be our next warning sign to check if we have done everything correct. So again, here and you can see here again, here is a stitch marker and we have done our last double crochet in the stitch before that, so that's correct. And then we will count again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's correct, because with each stitch marker you get 5 extra squares. I will mark this because well, now the counting is not so very very hard, but if the large piece you really want to have to recount it over and over again. So this was number 10, and then we will continue again, and I haven't done my chain yet. So up to the next stitch marker, and I will do this quickly because you will now get what I'm doing. So this goes very quickly, and take some yarn. I haven't done my chain yet. So, almost there. And again, you can see here, I have come to my stitch before the warning post. And this is number 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So that's correct, and then we have come to our last part. So make the chain, and 5 more times. Almost there. This is why I told you to make that first stitch of the setup a bit loose, because if you've done that too tight, it will be very hard to push through the hook. And then we will check again. So this was number 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So that's correct. So now we have finished row 1A. Okay, we have now done our row 1A, but if you look at the design, you have done now this pink part here, but you see that the interlocking with color 2 hasn't took place yet, and that is what we will do now. And we will be doing that by weaving in this chain through these holes of color 1. I will take my small example. You can see here this bottom row, and you will be weaving this through. You can see here the first one goes on top, and then the next goes, or the post of the double crochet, if the color one goes to the back, to the front, to the back, to the front. You can also see that in this chart. This is the side double crochet, this is this one. And you can see here the next one is in the gray. I will call it gray, because otherwise you maybe get confused with blue. This is row one, and it's pink. So the post of the double crochet is lying behind color two. The next double crochet, you can see that with the dots here, is laying in front of color two. Here is it laying at the back, here is laying at the front. So we will weave it through. And first of all, you lay it down, and you have to check that you that the end of, yeah, where you finished your row is on this side, on top. So not like this. This is correct. And you will be starting to weave with this side, and you have to start here and go to that way, that side. Okay, as you can see also in the example here, the first part goes on top. You can also see that in the chart here. So, and the next row, it also goes on top. So we have to start here on this side. So this goes on top. So it goes, this is the side, double crochet. This is the next double crochet, and the next double crochet goes to the back. And then the third double crochet goes on top. So we will take the end and pull it to the back. Now there's one thing that I really want you to pay attention to, and that is that I will show it to you. These V-stitches, you want to have them face you nicely. I will show you. Before you know it, you turn everything around, and then when you crochet through, they have to crochet your next row, then that will really be a problem. So please take care that your V-stitches are nicely laying here. So now we have done our first weave, and then we have to come up again. Well, don't pay too much attention to where your stitch markers should be. That will all be nice. So just weave it through, and I will do that. And well, I will see you back when I've woven it through. Okay, I've woven my first chain through the color one squares, and well, you can see here. So this first one, it goes down into hole two, and it comes up again. And so the post of the second double crochet of color one is at the back, and this is on front, on the back, on the front. And well, you see all these stitch markers here. And well, I will just show you. In the large piece, we will do that differently, because here you have an idea how many stitch markers I have. And well, that you really don't want to do it this way, but for learning's sake, we will do it this way now. And a little sneak preview here. we will do it just a little bit different with the large piece. So, okay, we now did this, and we can also check at the end here with the chart. This is the last side double crochet, and you can see here that this previous double crochet of color 1 is behind color 2. So it was just up and down again, and well, this is a very simple pattern, so it's up, down, up, down, up, down, but well, you probably now can recognize how to do this if you have a different pattern. And well, then now we will start crocheting row 1B. Before we start crocheting, I want to mention you that there are two charts of the pattern. We are working on the front side at the moment, so we will use the chart of the front side. There is also a back side, and we will use that with the next row, but for now this is the front that we are still working on, and now we will do step 1B. So here I've marked the 1 in the chart, and now we will look at this row. With this chart I have made these circles around here to show you how to read this. This will not be in the pattern, it's just for learning sake for at the moment, because the chart only shows this. But for now, I will use this version so I can explain it a little bit better to you. So we will take our color 2, I will take some yarn. And, well, I will take this stitch marker out that prevented me from losing stitches. So, with the setup row, we did 39 chains. And also for this one, I will first do a double crochet, and I will do that by making 3 chain stitches, plus 1 extra for the chain stitch that goes in between the double crochet. So I will do 4 extra. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now, and this is why this stitch marker, this first stitch marker, is so handy. This first double crochet I'm making chain stitches is this one. We are working with the color 2. You can see here that the next double crochet has to fall behind color 1. So we have to make a double crochet, and I will make a wrap around my hook. And I will insert my hook into the back of this hole of the second square. I will take that loop here, I will pull it to the back, and I fold over my blue for blue row, and I will make my double crochet here. This is why I love to use this first stitch marker here, because you know, you have to count and you have to see where to insert your first stitch, and it will get better now we have done our first one. But this takes care that your first double crochet is in the right place. So now we can remove it. And now we can do our next double crochet. I first have to do the chain stitch. And we've just done this one. And now we will do this one. And this will be in front of color one. So I will first have to see where I have to make my my stitch. So I pull it a little bit to the front, and here is where I've done my stitch, and I have to skip one, and I have to insert my hook here. So I will wrap around and make my double crochet. So check, this is where I've done, skip, and here is my double crochet in front. It tends to shift a little bit, so I always use a stitch marker to keep it in place, the start of this row. So lock it down. Okay, we have now done this one, and now we will do this one, and that is, we have to look to the grayish, and that falls behind color one. So again, we have to work in the next hole, but into the back. So what I will do, you see here, I've done my stitch here. So this is the one that I have to skip. And this is the place where I have to make my next double crochet. So I wrap around my hook. I insert my hook to the front. And with the point of my crochet hook, I grab this and pull it to the back. And there I will finish my double crochet. And let's see if I did correct. So this is where, I think I've done it wrong. It's you know, it's very important to check and check and check. That's why the stitch markers are so important. So again, so you see now why it's so important to really look closely. So this is where I did it, and this is the stitch that I should have taken. So again, pull that loop to the back and make your stitch and a chain stitch, and then the next have to go to the front again. So we pull our chain row a little bit to the front to see where to insert our stitch. So here is the place where we've done our, I will take it a little bit so you can see better. Here's where I've done the previous one, and here is where we have to do our next one. So in the front, and you see now why this stitch marker is so important, because we have come to a stitch our last double crochet is made in the stitch before the stitch marker, so that is your checkpoint. Okay, I have counted correctly. You saw me make a mistake. You can see how easily that can happen with this first row. And I want to tell you, don't be discouraged by this first row. If you use the stitch markers and you place them in every 10th stitch, if you make a mistake, you can easily correct it. And so do yourself a favor, use these stitch markers. And now we will count how many squares we did. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's correct, because as I told you, the inner mesh has one square less than the outer mesh, so that is correct. So now we can remove this stitch marker, and we have done front, back, front, back, front, and then we will do the second one in the back again. So we will have to see which loop to take. So this is where our last one was, this is skipped, and then we will use this one. So insert your hook, grab that loop, and so now I will do one more. So this is also why it's so important to have this chain that you did here, that you have woven it in a nice way, because you will probably know or see that if it's all twisted, then you have to look at that also. So if you've done that nicely, then this will get more easy. So here is where our last stitch was. We will skip this one and we will insert our hook in this one. Here we do our double crochet. And we will continue like this. And, well, you know, I will do a couple of more until I've come to the last of the next stitch marker. So we can check. So one more time. Now we have to get to the back. So skip one, this is the stitch that we have to grab. So, okay, look, if I took the correct one. Get some yarn. Make our, and then the next goes to the front again. So, you see, this stitch marker can get in the way a little bit, but okay. So check again, here we did our stitch, so we have to be here again and we have to work in the front. One chain, and then we have the next go into the back again. So we have done our stitch here, and then we have to insert our hook here, and you can already see now this is the stitch before the stitch marker, so you can already see that's correct. So we have now done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, because with every stitch marker you will get five extra squares. So we started with 4, so now we have 5, and with the next you should have 13, and with the last one you should have 19. So I will continue doing this row until the end, and then I will get back to you. I've finished row 1B with color 2, and it should now look like this. You can see here, this is on top of color 1, the next one is on the back of color 1, the next one is on top of color 1, and the next is on the back. And, well, you can always check also at the end. And you can see here, the last one here is on the back, and that's correct, and the previous one is on the front. And it's all also a good thing to also check on the back. I've noticed that with some patterns, if you made a mistake, it somehow seems to show up better on the other side. So always check, also check on the back side. And well, Now I've learned you how to look at the pattern, but some people prefer written directions, and I have made a shorthand kind of way for it. And I will also provide it on my website. If you look at this, we have done row 1B. With the shorthand, I don't tell you how to do your first double crochet at the start of the row. I don't tell that you have to do the single crochets or the chain stitches in between the double crochets. You know that in these directions, I only tell you where the double crochets have to be. And so you see here, for row 1B, we work at the front side. So it's front, back, 10 times. So front, back, and then 10 times. For the A rows, and well, you know, I will show you that in the next row.